This video is about these three options. If you have multiple monitors and you run multiple presentations together, this is very useful. So here is the setup. On the left side, we see the second monitor on which I'm presenting, and that is the monitor which is shared in this Teams meeting. I have three other presentations open. I'm going to start with Copilot Masterclass. So I click on the desired slide in this PPT and run current slide. Now the audience is seeing this slide. I suddenly want to switch to this slide in a completely different PPT. I select the slide and again choose the run current slide option. Now you'll see without any disturbance visually on the audience side, one slide smoothly went to the other. Now while that is happening, I want to come back to a Copilot slide. So I go to the desired slide in Copilot, run it, and now that works. In the meantime, I want to jump to some completely different slide in a third presentation. It's still related to the storytelling, but I am choosing slides, technically speaking, at random across different presentations. So if you use multiple monitors and multiple presentations like this, this button will make your presentations much smoother and more impactful. Mind you, the presenter view does not help here because presenter view shows only one PPT at a time. I wish there was a drop down there, but as of now, it's not. So there you have it, run current slide. And when I finish the presentation, you can see there are multiple presentations running. So if I want to edit something after my session is over, I have to manually stop all presentations. That's why I wrote this small little macro which says stop all shows. And what does it do? It just closes all of them and maximizes all PPTs. Why is that required? Because typically after a session, I have some ideas about some slide to be changed, something to be added, reorganizing slides, whatever. So having those in maximized view is easier to edit. Now let's see when to use the remove unused layouts option. It's typically useful in case of large presentations. For example, here I have 279 slides. The size of this file is 580 MB. Because over a period of time, a lot of new slides are added, copy paste happens. Every time you copy paste something, the underlying slide master also gets copy pasted. So when I go to slide master, this is the first slide master and it has many slides below it. These are the layouts in this slide master, so many of them. And then this is where the second one starts. And again, there are many layouts like that. There may be lots of unused layouts because they are occupying space and they also increase the clutter. You can't simply select and delete all of them because some of them are used by slides. So instead of doing it manually, which is going to take a very long time, you simply go to our add-ins and say remove unused layouts. Say there are seven designs. Designs means slide masters with 367 layouts. So I have more layouts than I have slides. And out of them, majority are not used. So it's asking you, do you want to delete? You see yes. Now when it is finished, it will tell you all okay. And now when you go back, you will see only the used ones being kept. So now the presentation is much more manageable. It will also reduce some file size. More importantly, when you want to change the slide layout, there is a much shorter list to choose from that reduces confusion. Always make a copy and then do it. So in case there is a mistake, you still have the original backup. You can also download this add-in. It's a PPAM file. If you want to learn the programming behind it, you also download the PPTM file. In either case, after you download the file, right-click on it, go to properties and unblock it. Create a folder called macros and put it there. Next step is to install this add-in. Go to file menu. Options, add-ins. Here you will see COM add-ins. Change that to PowerPoint add-ins. Click on Go, Add New, and choose the PPAM file which you just saved somewhere. Once it is done, remember to enable this checkbox. And once you do that, you will get an add-in button here or add-in tab In the add-ins menu, you will see all the macros we have created. My friend Raj has done all the programming. This is a quick description of what other tools do, and we have separate videos for all of them. This video is about run current slide, stop all shows, and remove unused layouts. The most important is run current slide. This is a button I need very frequently, so the first step is to add to quick access toolbar. This is my quick access toolbar. In your case, it may be on top. Right click on it, customize quick access toolbar, open this drop down and search for add-ins tab. You will see the run current slide. Select it, but don't add it yet. On the right side, it'll show you all the buttons which you already have in the quick access toolbar. Select the first button and now click on the add button. So left side run current slide, right side whatever is your first button, add. Now run current slide is in second position. Use this up arrow to move it to the first position. Click OK. So add-ins tab has this button and the same button is now available here. Alt 1 will be the shortcut for it. So try it out and let me know if you like it. Share it with as many people as you can so that everyone can benefit from this. That's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.